Hey there, this is Dr. Evan Osar with the Institute for Integrative Health and Fitness Education. Welcome to this edition of Integrative Movement Insider. In this series of Integrative Movement Insider, we're talking about thoracic rotation or thoracic mobility, and we're going to look at a very simple assessment, which is thoracic rotation. Recall from part one, so if you missed that, watch that one after you watch this video, because I describe in it and discuss the reasons why our clients lose thoracic mobility. Number one, yes, it's the sedentary lifestyle. Many of our clients just aren't moving and exploring range of motion. Number two, however, it's how our clients are using their muscles. And too many of our clients are gripping from their abdominal wall, they're gripping from their glutes, they're gripping from their lats to pull their shoulder blades down and back, and that starts to lock up thoracic mobility. And that's why so many of our clients, when they do thoracic mobility drills, or after they should say, after they do thoracic mobility drills, or after they see the chiropractor, or they see the massage therapist or physical therapist, they feel great, oh, I feel awesome, I feel range of motion, I feel tall, long. However, they're unable to maintain that range of motion or mobility because they go right back into their old habits and the gripping habits around their abdominal wall, pulling their abs in or bracing down, pulling down with their shoulder blades, and are squeezing the glutes and tightening up the thoracic erectors. So one of the things we need to do is identify those patterns, those habits in our clients, and help them start to relax and release, let go of some of those gripping habits. And gripping is really just a neurological, it can happen at a conscious level, but a lot of times it's at an unconscious level. It's a neurological reflex sometimes after surgery, injury, and or trauma. It's also a conscious process. Like some clients just pull their abs in, hold their glutes tight because that's what they think they should do, or that's what they've been told to do. So whether it's a conscious process or a reflexive unconscious process, or it's become an unconscious process because it's been so conscious for so long, we want to help our clients identify where they're gripping and teach them how to let go and release when they don't need to grip, which is most of everyday life. The third reason why clients lose thoracic mobility is they use strategies that just don't facilitate and maintain thoracic mobility. So for example, they go into the gym and they'll do things where they lift their chest up and squeeze down and back. And again, they just basically lock up their thoracic mobility. So many of our older clients are stuck in these kyphotic positions, and when we try to cue them out of these positions, we actually just make them worse because what we do is we cue them to arch their back, and if they're kyphotic, they're not going into extension and getting out of their kyphotic posture. So we want to give them strategies to improve their alignment, improve how we're cueing them so we're not facilitating and feeding into, perpetuating their thoracic immobility. Now, a very simple and easy assessment to look at your client's thoracic mobility is to look at thoracic rotation, the range of motion through the thoracic spine. So what you have your clients do is just sit, and we usually use a yoga block, we'll put it between the knees just to kind of keep their knees stationary, keep their pelvis stationary, and to create pure thoracic mobility or spinal rotation. We cross our arms over, and we just have them rotate to one side, come back to center, and be real deliberate about coming back to center, because a lot of our clients are just doing this, and they'll be like, I feel pretty similar side to side. Because what you want to pick up on is your client's asymmetry side to side. And I know there's a lot of discussions about, oh, we're asymmetrical because we're right-handed, or maybe we play a sport. What we want is relative symmetry in our clients' range of motion, especially our clients, our general population clients that aren't playing one-sided sports or one-sided activities like tennis or golf and or baseball or throwing baseballs. Because we don't want to see huge differences in range of motion because that will impact our clients and how they do everyday activities of life. So again, cross arms over, go slow, see how far they can go. Note if there's any discomfort, any range of motion issues as far as like, I just feel stiffer or tighter or more restricted, come back to center, stop, and then rotate you to the side. And just check that three times each side. And for me, it feels a little more restricted to my left side, feel a little something in my low back as I go to my left side. Also, you want to observe your client, you want to help them identify their more restricted side or get their feedback, but then also you look at them and identify their more restricted side, because sometimes clients go further, so they feel more restriction on the side they're going further to because they're like, oh, because they're going further, so they actually feel or are more aware of restrictions on their more mobile side. So you watch them and see if it matches what your client is saying. Once you determine your client's more limited side, now we want to go into our strategy. So we'll do our myofascial release work. We'll use our trigger point devices, our foam rolls. We use manual therapy in our clinic. So use whatever you use and have used with success to help your clients release areas of gripping, QL, thoracic erectors, lumbar erectors, thoracolumbar fascia, lats, glutes, all those muscles that can restrict the myofascial structures around the thorax and lumbar spine. Now, our go-to strategy for improving thoracic mobility and therefore thoracic rotation and therefore how our clients are stabilizing their core is three-dimensional breathing. Three-dimensional breathing to us refers to breathing from the first rib, which is right behind the clavicle or collarbone, all the way down to the ischial tuberosities, to the pelvic floor, going side to side and front to back. Belly breathing is not three-dimensional breathing. Belly breathing is not even efficient use of the diaphragm. It may be slightly better than using chest breathing, but just slightly better. It's not three-dimensional breathing. It's not using the entire thoracopelvic cylinder in the breathing process. We need our clients to actually breathe through their rib cage, because most of our clients are not expanding their rib cage like a cylinder. That's why we refer to it as the thoracopelvic cylinder. They're just breathing this way by extending up and then flexing down. Extending as they breathe in and flexing as they breathe out. So a great way to start to get your clients to start to learn how to breathe through their rib cage is using a strap. So what we'll do is have our clients just place a yoga strap. And if you don't have a yoga strap, you can just use a bath towel and just have them cross the yoga strap out across their chest, right underneath their arms, and just pull it taut gently. So they don't need to crush themselves, just gently pull it taut, because I want them to be able to feel expansion of the entire thorax, especially through the lateral sides or the sides, and also through the back. So they're gonna breathe in, and then breathe out. Breathing in, and then breathing out. Breathing in through the nose, expanding into the strap, and breathing out. And we usually will do this in the happy baby position, but we also want to do it in the upright position. However, the happy baby position allows our clients to relax and get into their most neutral alignment, to relax their hips, to relax their spine, it relax the effects of gravity. Again, just create a little tension on the strap, breathing in, and focusing on expanding that rib cage side to side, front to back, and also that sort of top to bottom cylindrical expansion. Again, breathing in and breathing out. Breathing in and breathing out. One last thing, make sure your client's head and neck are supported, so that way their head and neck are in alignment with their thoracopelvic cylinder, because that will also facilitate relaxation of the neck muscles and allow them to use the intercostals, the diaphragm, and all those primary muscles of respiration, and decrease overuse of their head and neck, which is another reason our clients will oftentimes lose thoracic rotation. When you're done, put the yoga block between your client's legs, arms crossed, and just recheck range of motion, and big change in my range of motion just from doing those few simple breaths. Very powerful, even though it's a very simple technique, because a lot of the strategies that will help your clients are very simple, and that's why they sort of blow them off or don't pay attention to them, because they're not these dramatic, dynamic sort of activities or movements. It's these subtle changes in alignment and breathing and control that can make powerful differences in your clients. Of course, you want to train this in the upright position, and you also want to train this through your client's movement patterns. So in part three of this video series, I'm going to show you how to take this thoracic mobility you just gained, this three-dimensional breathing strategy, take it into a rotation pattern, so you truly teach your clients how to rotate their entire rib cage, so those thoracic rings, the rib cage, as well as the thoracic spine, so they maintain alignment of the thoracopelvic cylinder and create pure trunk rotation, pure rotation as they're doing their functional movement patterns. This is Dr. Evan Osar. Make a great day, make a great weekend. Next week we'll discuss not only thoracic mobility and rotation and how to take this into functional patterns, we're also going to be opening up our registration for the Integrative Movement Specialist Certification course, which is our course that we usually run once a year, but now we're actually opening up a second time because we've had so much demand. So watch out for the Integrative Movement Specialist Certification course so that you develop your expertise and be that specialist your clients need, want, and will seek out. Make it a great weekend. We'll see you next week.